The rules that we are going to comment on were described by Linkoff in 1971 to locate the primary retinal tear in decumbent retinal detachment. After that date, they were rethought, appearing a new modified version. But in this video, we will talk about the original Linkoff rules, those described by him in 1971. We can describe them with some very useful rules that allow us to identify the precise location of the retinal tear in 96% of cases of detachment of the primary decumbent retina. First, we are going to make a series of clarifications. Retinal detachment can be of three types: decumbent, tractional, or edematous. The decumbent retinal detachment is one that is produced by a break in continuity in the retina, usually a hole or tear. These rules will be useful in decumbent retinal detachment and should not be used in the other two types. On the other hand, retinal detachment may be primary or it may be a recurrence of a previous retinal detachment. These rules are going to be useful and we should use them in primary decumbent retinal detachment. They are not so useful to us in cases of relapse or re-detachment. We have also said that these rules allow us to locate the primary retinal tear that will cause the retinal detachment. But what happens when there is not a single break? What happens in cases of multiple retinal tears? Well, if there are multiple retinal breaks, the retinal hole that is located in a higher place is the one that is considered primary retinal break. The first rule will be useful in superior temporal or superior nasal decumbent retinal detachment, and it tells us that the primary retinal tear is found in 98% of cases within 1.5 hours of the highest border detachment, as we have represented in the figure by the two red lines. The second rule is used in those total or higher decumbent retinal detachment that cross the 12 o'clock meridian, which is the vertical meridian that passes over the optic disc. Well, in these cases, 93% of the time, the primary retinal break is at 12 o'clock. And if not, it will be found in a triangle whose vertex is located in the hora serrata at 12 o'clock and whose base extends from 11 to 1 hour. Rule number 3 is useful in inferior retinal detachments, and it says that in 95% of cases, the higher side of the detachment will indicate which side of the optic disc is the primary retinal tear, and that tear it will be located below the horizontal meridian. In those inferior detachments that have edges that are equally high on both the left and right of the optic disc, the tear is in the lower retina at 6 o'clock. Linkoff's fourth and final rule is useful in bullous inferior retinal detachments. In these cases, the primary retinal break will be located above the horizontal meridian. And in those cases of symmetric inferior bullous retinal detachment, with equal height on one side of the optic disc as on the other, they will be usually be caused by a small retinal hole that is located near 12 o'clock. Finally, remember that the link of rules help us in rheumatogenous retinal detachments. In primary retinal detachments and, if there are multiple retinal breaks, the highest retinal hole will be considered the primary retinal break.